Yo, it is good, yo. It's your boy Todd back here with another video. And in this video today, we are going to be talking about what is coming tomorrow in NBA 2K21. My team, my thoughts on it. What do I think is coming in? How it is going to affect the game in general. Now, before we dive into each and every one of those things, if you are new to my channel and have not yet, please consider smashing that subscribe button as we are on the road to 70,000 subscribers. So we're just gonna scroll through my team's Twitter today to kind of just see what happened. So this was the first thing that just randomly got tweeted at 4 o'clock Central Time today. It said, tag the best my team player you know. Obviously a lot of people, you know what I'm saying? A lot of people had their thoughts on this thing. Ronnie, I don't know why, said, how do I tag myself? Like, imagine Ronnie. If I was playing Roddy, the score would be about 900-2. But that is besides the point, okay? That is what happened. And then they said, prove that you're the best starting tomorrow. So then this is what really got people thinking. I know a lot of people were talking to me like, Ty, they're going to have another tournament, which obviously I was like, you know, I don't think that's the case. I think they would have hyped it up more than just this. But I started thinking, at this point, I was like, are they going to make a mode that's somewhat competitive, similar to like a weekend league type mode? Just something like that. Carlos tweeting about him, like, Carlo, just a lot of people tweeting about stuff that they should not be tweeting about. But prove that you're the best starting tomorrow was another tweet that just kind of got people interested in what was going on. And then this came out, new spotlight sim tomorrow, 30 intense challenges, 30 new dark matter rewards, and one invincible reward for completing every challenge. Now we're gonna break this down. New spotlight sim tomorrow. How is a spotlight sim going to prove anything that you're the best starting tomorrow? Those two tweets do not go together. Spotlight sims, I guess the Bill Russell spotlight sims were super hard, but that does not prove that you're the best. But it does include 30 new intense challenges as well as 30 new dark matter rewards. So for every challenge that you get through, you are going to get a dark matter reward. Now we'll see how those rewards are and if they can compete against some of the best cards in the game. Now something to notice about here. One invisible reward for completing every challenge. And you guys see the emoji. I don't need to talk too much about it. It's Tuesday right now. Not Tuesday, tomorrow. But Taco Tuesday Invincible is probably coming tomorrow. I don't want to say for sure, but I'm almost guaranteeing it for you guys. Otherwise, I do not think they would have used that emoji. So Taco Fall Invincible card coming tomorrow, which in its own right is just going to change the game. Just think, he has the Joel Embiid type base. He's going to be absolutely broken in this game. So that's what's to come tomorrow. Now again, that's the only tweets we have received. Obviously, idols have been coming out every Wednesday as well. So are we going to see those tomorrow, or are they going to push those back to Thursday? I'm not quite sure. So what can we see tomorrow as far as these 30 intense challenges? Is it going to be triple threat offline again? Is it going to be like a domination type mode in which there are 5 minute quarters, 4 minute quarters, or is it going to be a combination of both? Alongside with that, some people, including I think DBG tweeted out today, it has to be some type of multiplayer mode, which if proving that you're the best starting tomorrow, I mean, that's the whole thing. These tweets don't align. Spotlight sims and proving that you're the best do not align. So that's the whole thing. I mean, when people think of spotlight sims, they don't think of competitive my team in general. They just think of, you know, they just think of getting the cards, right? How many people have Bill Russell that aren't necessarily the best at the game? There's quite a few people. Now, do you have to be above average to probably get Bill Russell? Absolutely. So, I mean, we'll see what all this entails tomorrow. Do I wish there was a more competitive mode maybe coming within NBA 2K21 my team? I absolutely do. But does that take away from what we are possibly going to get tomorrow with the Spotlight Sims? It absolutely doesn't. I'm still excited for tomorrow in general. I think tomorrow is going to be a big type of content day. It's going to get the community excited because any sort of free grind, because we haven't seen a lot of good free players this season so far. So any good free players that come tomorrow is going to be incredible. So that gets me thinking, right? What am I searching? Imagine me searching Thon. Let's search Taco Fall. So here's the thing. 30 intense challenges and 30 new dark matter rewards. So my question is this. If we're only seeing 30 dark matter rewards, is that including the Taco Fall? Is that 30 separate ones? Because for every challenge, you get a dark matter and then just the one invincible card. So 31 new cards tomorrow. That's probably what I'm guessing. 7'5", 8'2" wingspan. Just think about that. And here's the thing about Taco Fall. He's going to have hot spots where he's going to have 99 everything, basically every shooting badge, maybe outside of range in the game. He's going to have the jump shot 47, Embiid's base, Coey's upper on very quick, which we all know what that release is going to be like. It's going to be one of the most easy releases to time within the game. So expect Taco Fall to be the new best player within NBA 2K21, my team. I'm sorry for everybody that locked in for the Bulbul card, but how are you going to see? How am I supposed to see here and tell you that Taco is not going to be better than Bulbul? He's 7'5", guys, with an 8'2 wingspan. That is, just think of the Yao that we had last year. That's what this Taco is going to be like. So my thing is this that I want to explain to you guys. If proving that you're the best starting tomorrow, if that's how you get Taco Fall, everybody should not be able to get Taco Fall. And then when I say that, I mean that. 50% of the community should not be able to get it if you have to prove that you're the best starting tomorrow. If proving that you're the best starting tomorrow, there should be like 5% of users that do get Taco Fall. That's what I personally would like to see, because I want to get Taco, and the majority of people watching this video, I hope you guys don't be are able to get Taco. That's what I personally want. Is that what's going to come tomorrow? No. Because proving that you're the best tomorrow is going to mean absolutely nothing. What is going to mean something is the fact that we're getting Taco Fall. It is the end of June, so I can't really fault 2K at releasing the Invincible Taco Fall reward. What I'm kind of upset about is people who have Shaq, who have Kareem, who have those types of centers, that you're just going to be able to get Taco Fall and just dominate. For people who are no money spent like me, hopefully you don't have to have certain lineup requirements to get Taco Fall. Hopefully I can just do it with whatever MT I have and not necessarily have to sit there and worry about it. Because if I could get Taco Fall on my no money spent squad team, think about it like this. You get Luka, you get Blake, you get Taco, you got Bill Russell, you got Danny Ferry. You can put those pieces together and basically an all reward type of team. You get Moses Malone at the end of the season as well. And you're starting to really look at a lineup that could compete against some of the best. So specifically with tomorrow, again, you get 30 new Dark Matter rewards as well. So maybe some of those are going to be absolutely incredible. It's hard for me to say for sure what to expect tomorrow as far as the grind. I would say I don't expect another triple threat offline grind. I do expect 2K to change it in a way, just because we've already seen triple threat offline spotlight sims. Although those did have their challenges in their own right, if this is the only for the best, expect those challenges, but maybe even harder. And I don't want that. When I say I want just the top few to be able to get Taco Fall, it's not what I'm saying. I don't want the challenges in offline to get harder. Double-double with James Worthy against the Looney Tunes, where it's just impossible, dude. You shouldn't have to do it. It shouldn't be that hard. So hopefully these Spotlight Sims, I'm hoping, guys, what I want is for everybody to be able to get this done, quite honestly. Now, if this is, I want this for just to be for the very few people who are some of the top guys in the game. That's what I'm saying. These two shouldn't go together. Spotlight Sims should not go with this. We'll see what 2K ends up deciding to do. If they have certain challenges, like within just 5-on-5, like 5-minute quarters, like beat them by 100 points, yes, it's going to be a long, long day tomorrow. But maybe if it's like that, I'll do it. I'll participate in trying to get the first Taco Fall. I'm just still burnt out at trying to get the first Bill Russell. So we'll have to see what it looks like tomorrow and if I do decide to grind for Taco Fall. But let me know down below in the comments. First things first, let me know if you guys are excited about this content, about the new Spotlight Sims. Are you guys concerned about this tweet? Let's say you just play the game for fun and aren't the best. Are you concerned that 2K is going to go with something like that? Or do you guys just not worried about that? Because that tweet, like I said, they just don't go together, and it just doesn't really make sense to me in general how those tweets at all go together. But that's besides the point. I'm personally super excited about Taco Fall. I honestly want to be the first person to get him, so maybe we'll try that out. We'll just have to see how tomorrow does indeed go in general. But that is going to wrap it up for the video today, guys, and I hope you guys did enjoy it. This card right here is coming as an Invincible card. If that doesn't make you excited, I don't know what does in NBA 2K21, my team, at this point. Think about the Yao that we had last year. Taco Fall is going to be even better. I hope you guys did enjoy this video today. Drop a like on the video. Subscribe if you are new. And as always, man, I love you guys. Have a blessed day.